You're at 3302 Country Club Drive, St. Clair Shores, Michigan.
And the owners of Toyology will be talking about the importance of imagination, educational toys, and the idea that play teaches kids life skills.
Even the importance of playing a game and learning how to take turns and giving and being a good sport and learning how to give compliments. And then language develops from that. There is so much learning that happens.
Gift card. And if you lost money, we think it's valuable to kind of take a look at the police. That way you've got an official record of what happened.
Mendez suggests that everyone enables two-factor authentication on their accounts as it will give another layer of protection. Well, the Powerball jackpot is approaching $400 million since there were no winning tickets for last night's game. Right now, the prize for Saturday's drawing will be at least $378 million. That is nearly $199 million if you happen to take that cash option. The Mega Millions jackpot is up there as well. It is estimated at $410 million for tomorrow's drawing. It is the third time this year that the jackpot has surpassed the $400 million mark. WMJ News time is 1:18. It is time for traffic and weather together on the 8th Street. The Casco is watching.
Still keeping an eye on a busy drive here. This report sponsored by Hartford and Bradley. So checking the AAA jam cams. Delays ongoing in Sterling Heights. The crash at 18 and a half miles. And the Van Dyke roundabout remain eastbound. 18 and a half mile is closed. So is southbound Van Dyke. Slower traffic ongoing eastbound I-94 from Livernois to I-96. The right lane closed. Southbound is on I-75 still dealing with delays from Canfield to Brush. Moving work through on the right shoulder. Westbound 696 from Hallstrad through the 275 interchange. Delays ongoing. Dearborn Heights delays. Telegraph slow both ways between I-94 and Michigan Avenue. And here eastbound I-94 and M-59. A right lane closure in the 94 eastbound ramps to westbound M-59. Closed for ongoing work as well. Fall in Michigan means it's time to prepare for winter weather. Call Harper and Bratliff, the original furnace and hot water specialist. Financing is available, so don't wait. Schedule service or get an estimate at HartfordandRatliff.com. HartfordandRatliff.com. Let me next look at traffic here, 128, McGrath Roofing Traffic Center.
And from the AccuWeather forecast from the Bill Brown Ford Weather Center.
Heading into the afternoon, breezy and warm still, with temperatures up in the low to mid 70s today, with clouds and sunny peaks. It'll turn colder tonight, a couple of showers moving through. We'll end up in the 40s, get back in the low to mid 50s at best tomorrow afternoon. Windy and chilly with some sprinkles or a shower. Real feels in the 40s, and then we'll moderate into the upper 50s with sunshine Saturday, low to mid 60s on Sunday. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Ian DeVore, WWJ News Radio Lane 50.
In Livonia this hour, partly cloudy, 74 degrees. We have 75 downtown, and we have 72 here in Southfield. Well, don't be surprised when you pass the gas station today and see higher prices. The cost of gas skyrocketed overnight. The average price for a gallon of regular gas in the state now $4.33, a 10-cent jump from yesterday's average. Midwest oil refinery fires are the reason for the price hike. And some people also worried about yesterday's announcement from OPEC, slashing oil production by 2 million barrels a day. But Gas Buddy analyst Patrick DeHaan says that impact should not be severe for Michigan drivers.
Michiganders probably won't even notice an impact from OPEC's decision. Like I said, prices should be moderating here in the next couple of weeks. The only way that Michiganders may feel it is that gas prices won't fall quite as far as they would have without OPEC cutting production. So I think Michigan will probably go back under the $4 a gallon mark in the next few weeks, so long as there are no new refinery issues.
DeHaan says the Midwest oil supply is beginning to recover. WWJ News time is 1:21, coming up at 1:23.
The Lions' number one offense is missing a whole bunch of players. Can they get anyone back? They practice preparing for the Patriots. Details coming up in sports.
Check out the Michigan Manufactured Housing Association showcase at Suburban Collection during the Novi Home Show October 7th through 9th. Tour six stunning homes from the industry.